The second auger system that we'll take a look at is in the Magnum Countryside and the Magnum Furnace. Both auger systems are very typical, as you can see, but the Countryside uses an 1.5-inch diameter auger system, and the Magnum Furnace uses a 2-inch auger system. But the styling is the same, and the motor operates in the same fashion. So what we're going to do is talk a little bit about how you would take this system apart should you get an auger jam and the fuel is tight in there and you cannot get it out. The first thing that you can do is if you come home and the auger is jammed, is take your finger after you've unplugged the unit and the unit is shut down, take and spin the propeller backwards on the auger. And doing this will actually turn all of the mechanisms in the auger motor backwards, which will back up the feed in the auger system, and it will not damage the motor. If you run into a situation where there's too much pressure on here and you're not able to remove it by simply turning the propeller backwards, then you're going to have to take the auger motor out and you're going to have to take the system out the front. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and take this apart. What you're going to do is take your Allen wrench, and loosen the locking collar and slide the motor out of the system. I'll turn this around and show you again. You've got your auger motor that slides in between these two cogs, and then you tighten up your collar here. Once you've taken the motor off, then you want to take the collar off here, and now the auger flighting would be able to slide out of the front of the unit. Now before you do that, make sure and empty the corn or wood pellets out of your hopper, vacuum everything out of the system that you can get vacuumed out, and then you're able to move this forward. If the auger is jammed in place and does not want to simply move out, do not take and put a vice grip or some other form of wrench on the flighting. You will damage the flighting. So what you want to do, if you're running into a problem with that, is take the collar and put that back on and just tighten down on the screw just a little bit and move this back and forth, dislodging the fuel. Once that's done, you're able to freely move the auger and move it forward. If the auger is jammed in so tight that you're not able to move this freely, then you have two options that you have to take a look at. One would be to take the collar back off again, and using a 3/8 diameter punch, you would insert that into the end of the auger and gently tap on it until the auger starts to come out the front of the appliance. Once the auger starts coming out the front, you're able to move it loose and take the auger flighting right out of the tubing. Now, whether this is on the furnace or on the Countryside models, it's the same thing. The auger will come out the front, like we have it here, and you're able to dislodge the fuel. Once you have it out, you're going to want to do an inspection on the inside tube of here, and typically you'll shine a light in there and make sure that there aren't any nicks and scratches. If you find out that whatever you've gotten caught in here has caused some gouging or some cuts into the inside of the tube, you're going to want to go to the local hardware store and pick yourself up a flap wheel, something like this. Is 1.5-inch diameter for the Countryside and a 2-inch diameter for the furnace, and you would put this in here, hook it onto a drill, and hone that out until the inside is nice and smooth again. If you're not able to pick up one of these, or if you're not able to have a drill handy, you can take a piece of emery cloth and wrap it around something that's approximately an inch in diameter and work that in and out of the tube to get that done. Once that's finished, then you'll reinsert the auger flighting back in, making sure that it spins very freely, and also make sure that you've inspected all of the flightings on here, and if there are any nicks or bends, you would want to straighten them and polish them off very well to make sure that the fuel can flow through without any problems. Once the auger system is ready to put back together again, you're going to want to slip the collar into place and just barely get it started. And then when you go to put the motor back on, you want to remember there's a flat on the auger motor shaft, and that flat needs to line up with the set screw on the collar. And so what you'll do is you'll actually either turn the auger or turn the shaft so that it's positioned right where you want it. And then you would slide that in and make sure that you lock the collar down onto the flat of the shaft. That way when it gets done, you've got the flat on the collar locked down onto the flat of the shaft.